بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على سيدنا محمد الصادق الوعد الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان ودعا بدعوتهم إلى يوم الدين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله قال سبحانه ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام أعطيت ما لم يعط أحد من قبلي وفي رواية أعطيت ما لم يعط أحد من الأنبياء ثم ذكر وجعلت أمتي خير الأمم أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. Respected brothers and elders and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We know that the last testament sent for the guidance of mankind is Kitabullah, the Book of Allah, Al-Qur'an al-Kareem, the Noble Qur'an. فِيهِ نَبَأُ مَا قَبْلَكُمْ وَخَبَرُ مَا بَعْدَكُمْ. The Qur'an has information about all those people who passed before us, about the nation, the ummah that lived before us. Also, وَخَبَرُ مَا بَعْدَكُمْ, and all the events that will unfold in front of us, all that information also mentioned in the Holy Qur'an. Brothers and sisters, when we study the Qur'an, we read about the ummah, the umam, the nation that lived before us. We know that Nuh alayhi salatu salam, he also raised an ummah. We also know that Prophet Lut alayhi salatu salam, he also raised an ummah. Likewise, Prophet Salih, Prophet Hud, Prophet Ibrahim, Ismail, Ishaq, Ya'qub, Yusuf, Yunus, Dawood, Sulaiman, and also Prophet Musa, Harun, and also Prophet Isa alayhi salatu salam. لِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولٍ. Every nation, every ummah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send them a messenger. وَلِكُلِّ قَوْمٍ هَادٍ. Every tribe, every nation, they have someone to guide them. وَإِن مِّن قَرْيَةٍ إِلَّا خَلَى فِيهَا نَذِيرٍ. Every village, they have someone to warn them. And there's a general principle in the Quran, وَمَا كُنَّا مُعَذِّبِينَ حَتَّى نَبْعَثَ رَسُولًا. That Allah Azza wa Jalla said that we do not punish any nation until we send them a Rasul, a messenger. Also, when we study the Quran, we understand that some of this ummah who lived before us, the lifespan was, compared to the lifespan of this ummah, was huge. Take for an example, Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. لَبِثَ فِيهِمْ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ إِلَّا خَمْسِينَ عَامًا. Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, he remained in his tribe, inviting them towards Allah for 1,000 years except 50, 950 years. And some of this ummah, subhanAllah, they were huge. For example, the tribe of Ad and Thamud. Some of the Mufassirin, they have mentioned that some of the children of Ad and Thamud, they used to reach the age of maturity when they used to be 300 years of age. Wallahu alam how true this is. But this ummah, we know the ummah who lived before us, they were huge, they were tall, they were big, they were gigantic. Take for an example, when Allah Azza wa Jal punished the tribe of Ad and Thamud, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran in Surah Al-Haqqa, what happened to Ad? That when the punishment of Allah came, their crops were on the floor. كَأَنَّهُمْ فَتَرَى الْقَوْمَ فِيهَا صَرْعَى. You see the bodies lying on the floor. كَأَنَّهُمْ أَعْجَازُ نَخْلٍ خَاوِيَةٍ. As if they were like palm trees pulled from the roots. Now Imam Al-Qurtubi, as you know, he's a mufassir, when he explained this verse, he says, actually, it means لِعِظَمِ أَجْسَادِهِمْ, that these people were actually huge. They were really big. And because of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that they were actually on the floor like palm trees pulled from the roots. But the question is, brothers and sisters, that people who lived before us, they had long lives, more than 950 years, some of them. They were taller than us. They were huge. They were big. They were gigantic. You know, despite all that, we find in the Holy Quran that Allah Azza wa Jal, the exalted, the most merciful, the compassionate, the majestic, He announced in the Holy Quran, Kuntum khayra ummah. That, O Ummah of Muhammad, O Ummah of Ahmad, you are the best of nation. You are the selected ones. You are the chosen one. This Ummah, we don't have anything that we have. We just talked about all the other Ummah. They had everything. They tick all the boxes. But what is it that we do? What do we deserve for Allah Azza wa Jal to call us that we are the best of nation? We are the chosen one. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in a hadith mentioned by Imam Ahmad in his Musnad, and Imam Ibn Kathir, he said the hadith is Hasan. The hadith is sound. The hadith is authentic. That Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, U'titu khamsan. Wa fi riwayatin u'titu ma lam yu'ta ahadun min al-anbiya. That Allah has given me preference with many things that none of the other anbiya, other prophets have been blessed with this. Consequently, the ummah has been blessed with many things. Then the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he listed a few things. And right at the end he says, Wa ju'ilat ummati khayra al-umam. My ummah is the best of all other ummah. Again, the same question comes. Why? And we have to find this answer. As you ruminate this answer, let me move on. Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala, who says that if anyone at the time of Bani Israel, if they was to make one mistake, mistake basically means, he gave an example, Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, may Allah be pleased with him and his father as they both accepted Islam, radiallahu anhuma, he says that if anyone is to go to for the call of nature, to relieve himself, and if he is to urinate, if any drop of urination is to touch his body, any parts of the body, the only way they could purify themselves by cutting off that piece of meat. Can you imagine this kind of things occurring in our time? No, it's not going to happen because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had mercy on this ummah. Allah has forgiven this ummah and all this hardship has been removed. وَيَضَعُ عَنْهُمْ إِسْرَهُمْ وَالْأَغْلَالِ All the hardship has been removed because of the blessing of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we have this affiliation with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, you probably read in the books of Tahara, and I believe everyone here, most of us are students of Ibrahim College. If you studied fiqh, then the way to purify yourself is just by simply rinsing with water. Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma also gives another explanation that anyone from the Bani Israel, if they should commit any sin, then his name and the sin that he has committed and the compensation of the sin is to be written on the door. So-and-so is an adulterer, for example, and he has committed adultery with so-and-so, and the compensation that both of them will be stoned. As an example, this is to be written on the door by the angels. So you cannot go and, you know, just paint over it. And the entire community the next morning is to be aware of it. And they're all talking about it, that bring so-and-so to justice and etc. And then, you know, whatever the consequences he will face. As for this ummah, subhanallah, many of us that we commit sins, unless we tell others, because we have another bad habit now, when we commit sins, we'd like to tell others as well. That is the problem that we have in our society as well. You know, by the use of Twitter or MSN or Messenger or Facebook and etc., we like to tell everyone that I am doing these sins, come and join me. That's something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't forgive, unless this person, he does tawbah openly. Nevertheless, Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma says that the person is to commit a sin at the time of Bani Israel, his name is to be written there. And also the compensation and etc. But this ummah, because of the blessing of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because this ummah is the chosen ummah in the eyes of Allah, because this ummah is the best of ummah in the eyes of Allah, if anyone commits a sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he hides his sins. And also our Prophet of Allah told us sallallahu alaihi wasallam, man satara musliman satarahu Allahu yawm al-qiyamah, that we should look after one another. If you see any faults, we should hide it. We should not expose his faults. You know, we like to tell everyone that so and so is doing etc. and etc. No. He said, hide it, because if you hide a Muslim brother's or sister's sins, then on the day of Qiyamah, Allah will hide all your sins. This is a special ummah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves this ummah. This is why when you commit a sin, it's not written. Otherwise, imagine, brothers and sisters, you know, it is written on our door. You know, the sins that we have committed. And mine or your name is written there, for example. And it's written, so-and-so has been sending haram text messages in the night. He had it. He's finished now. Or so-and-so has been browsing haram websites, example. Do you think this person could face his friends the very next day? Can he come to work now, for example? What's going to happen to him in his community? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept this secret, that if this servant of Allah, if he or she repent and does tawbah, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive this person. Why? Simply because this ummah is the chosen ummah. The chosen ummah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is dealing with this ummah differently than any other ummah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has also said in another hadith about this ummah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed this ummah with many things that other ummah has not been blessed. And the Prophet of Allah mentioned many things. In short, brothers and sisters, this ummah is the dearest ummah in the eyes of Allah. But the question again comes, why? Because we don't know, what is it that we have? Allah Azza wa Jal, He says in the Quran, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. This jumla here, this verse here, according to ulama of grammar, nahwa, it's called jumla mu'allala. And again, I'm using this word because many of you are students, or you're going to be studying, inshallah, nahwa and sarf with scholars at Ibrahim College. Jumla mu'allala, it's a causal sentence. Why this ummah has been given this preference? Allah Azza wa Jalla in the same verse mentioned the reason. Kuntum khayra ummah, you are the best of ummah. Ukhrijat min nas, you've been taken out for the guidance of mankind. And here's the reason now. Ta'muruna bil ma'ruf wa tanhauna 'anil munkar. Because you will call towards good. You are the best of ummah because you call towards good and you forbid from evil. This is the reason why Allah Azza wa Jal has chosen this ummah and given preference to this ummah over all other ummah. Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, narrating this verse, he read this verse. He also went for a hajj one day. And you know, when you go for hajj, people like to listen to you sometimes. So those, some of the companions, they came and said, Umar ibn Khattab is a senior companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is the Khalifa of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is Amirul Mu'mineen, the second Khalifa of Islam. So they came to speak to him. They said, Umar, give us some advice. He said, Kuntum khayra ummah. He said, look, Allah Azza wa Jal, he said, Kuntum khayra ummah, that we are the best of nation. He said, this verse is specific to the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the understanding of Umar ibn al-Khattab, that this is not for everyone. It's not for people like me and you sitting here, according to Umar ibn al-Khattab. He said, this verse is specific to the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because every one of them is to be a da'i ila Allah. Every one of them is to call towards Allah. Their young one, their adult, the men, the women, everyone, they is to call towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he said, Allah said, kuntum. He didn't say antum. He's not including everyone. Then Umar ibn al-Khattab said, however, I believe that if anyone call towards good and forbid from evil, and if everyone also call towards good and forbid from evil, then that person will also be included in this verse and this praise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What he's trying to say is this, and in Arabic he said, مَنْ سَرَّهُ أَيَّكُونَ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ. If he pleases you to be amongst the ummah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has praised in the Quran, that this is the chosen ummah, if he pleases you to be amongst that ummah, فَلْيُؤَدِّي شَرْطَ اللَّهِ فِيهَا, then let him fulfill the condition. Let him also do exactly what the companions of Rasulullah ﷺ did. So respected brothers and sisters, the question is, are we calling towards good? Are we forbidding from evil? And you don't have to go far. Start from your own self. There are many things that we have. We need to invite ourselves towards good as well. We need to also stop ourselves from doing evil as well. Start from your own house. From your own self, then from your own house, from your family members, your colleagues, your friends, etc. And then to the society, then move on. Because according to Umar ibn al-Khattab, this is the reason why this ummah has been given preference over all other ummah. Some of us, we might say that, you know what, I have to do a degree before I call towards, you know, Allah. I have to first learn all the, you know, asalibu da'wah, the techniques of da'wah. I have to memorize certain hadith, I have to memorize certain verses of the Quran and etc. We don't find this in the Holy Quran. Because this is something that every ummah, every one of us is a da'i. Every one of us could invite towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't have to do a degree in order to call towards Allah. بَلِّغُ عَنِّي وَلَوْ آيَةً. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you know one verse, then convey from me. One verse. How many of us here could say that I don't even know a single verse? Any good thing that you know, convey to the others, because we are the ummah da'iyah. We are the ummah that will invite others towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah azza wa jal give us the tawfiq to become one of those ummah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has happily mentioned them in the Quran by saying, kuntum khayra ummah, aquli qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah.